Lord God. Touch back now, Lord God. Somebody in here need to hear a word tonight, oh Lord. Somebody came burdened down tonight, oh Lord. Lord, we ask that you just lift every burden right now, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God. We just say thank you right now, Lord God. We 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 thank you right now, Lord God. Lord, I ask that you just let me decrease, oh God. Let me decrease, Lord God, that you get the increase tonight, oh God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, we bless you right now.
Yes.
We bless you right now. Yes, God. You have your will.
Thank you, Lord.
This thing is real. this church.
Amen.
About this church.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Y'all need to get it right.
Amen.
Y'all wearing the pastor down, but what you doing for the pastor?
Jesus.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
When you need your life, you're paying if the pastor ain't got you, gonna try to find a way to help you.
Yes.
When y'all gonna help the pastor?
Jesus. Amen.
no Jesus, there's no God. But God gives us the ability to keep pushing, keep striving. You see the light, and the light is God, and you just keep pressing your way. Amen.
Amen.
You keep pressing your way. Amen.
Amen.
Because God is a God that He does not lie. Amen. He said he prepared a table before you. In front of your enemies, right?
Yeah.
He got it all laid out. Keep pressing.
Amen.
It don't matter who's against you.
Amen.
Keep pressing. Amen. And when you get there, you're going to see it all laid out.
Amen.
All your doubters, all your haters.
Yes.
Amen. But it don't really matter about them. See, they're just the people in place to make you keep pushing. Of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. See, God hates evil. He hates evil, and He wants you to hate evil. And anything that you hate, you don't want to take company with. Amen. Anything that you hate, see, you should hate what He hates. Amen.
Amen.
You should hate what He hates, and you should love what He loves. And the Bible said, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. He didn't just love you or me. He loved the world. Amen. He loved the world. And like my sister said, you know, we come here day in, week in, out, week in, week in, week out, you know. And church is just not prepared overnight. The pastor's sermon is just not overnight. You know, he's studying, he's praying all during the week. You know, a word ain't just fell a few minutes ago, right? You might get a revelation even while you're speaking, but you got to have that thing down in your belly. Amen. That's a job all in itself, because you got to have that thing down in your belly. And then you got your people that you have to pray for and you toil for, and God will put something on your spirit. You don't know which one of the sheep it applies to, but you know that you got to bring that word forth, because that's what God has entrusted in you. That's what He has placed you in place where you know that God is your provider, that He's your sustainer. You know, but you're trying to get through to the people. You know, you got to cry out for the people. You got to stand in the gap for the people. Amen. It's not just, they will think it's not just a job, it's an adventure. But it ain't always a sweet adventure. Amen. But you know what? Anything that God brings to you, you can get through it. And if this is what He gave you to do, then He's going to give you the tools to accomplish all that He has for you to do. Amen. So it's not by chance that this man and this woman is in this house this weekend. It's not by happen chance, but it's by a godly appointment. Amen. You see, she's doing something for this house, but she's also doing something that God has put in her, because it's building her in her ministry. Amen. It's building her on her utmost. Amen. The Bible says study to show thyself approved. And you know, that don't mean that you got to study to prove to God who He is. He knows who He is. He got to study. You got to study. You know why? Because sometimes when we doubt, if you know what you're talking about, you doubt if that's God's voice. You doubt, or you think that person knows more than you did. You don't excel. You don't push forth. You don't have that thrust. But when you study to show thyself approved, then you build yourself up. Amen. It's for self-edification, because God is God.
Amen.
And He's going to be God regardless of who you are. Regardless of your failures. Regardless of what goes on around you, regardless of that storm, God is still sitting on high, looking down low. He's still still waiting for you to say, Lord, help me. He said, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. He has everything laid out before you. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Y'all know I like that back talk. You got to talk to me.
Amen.
I'm kind of old school. They didn't just say, amen, Selah, whatever. Just let me know. You know, it's kind of confirmation. You hear me? I'm talking, but are you listening? You know? I'm not just talking out of my mouth, but you know, God has a word.
Amen.
You know, no matter what your qualifications are, God has a word for each and every one. And you know, I invite you to open your hearts, your ears, and your minds. Amen. And I'm supposed to be up here doing the welcome, so let me get on program. Amen.
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 Kevin Brown, Roundtree, on behalf of Minister Ronna Robbins and Lady Helen, Minister Helen, amen. We just want to welcome you. I want to just welcome them and thank them for these 3 days. Thank you for laboring. Thank you for all that you do. You see, we got to have the kingdom mindset. She don't go to this church, but it's a kingdom mindset. It's one God, one way, amen, one God. If we all could come together under that, just one God.
Yeah.
It's raining. We don't need but one umbrella. It got to be big, but one umbrella. Amen.
Yeah.
One God.
Yeah.
One way. Amen. So I just want to welcome you. I'm so glad you guys are here. Like I said to you earlier in the service, it's good to have guests. But when you're being appreciated, you like to have family around. So all your family, just so welcome home. Thank you. Thank you for being here. I mean, I missed a couple of days of myself. So, you know, but, you know, don't charge it to my heart. I was here in my heart and my spirit. Amen. But sometimes that body get tired and all of that. I ain't made no excuse, but amen. So I just want to welcome you, and I'm so glad to be here today. And I just want to say, get my two cents in to my pastors.
Amen.
My pastors. You my pastor now. My pastors. I want to say that I appreciate all you do. I see the labor. I know the back turmoil. And I might get a little pushy, but you know, that's my place. That's where God placed me.
Amen.
So, you know, no matter what I may do or you think you're tired of me, but I'm going to keep pushing because I see the greatness. I see where they're going. I caught the vision. Amen. I caught the vision. And I don't want to be slacking. I don't want to slack when it comes to catching the vision, because sometimes, you know, just like they had to hold Moses' arms up, and as long as they held the arms up, everything's okay, Pastor. I just want to know that I got you.
Amen.
I got you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So I just want to say that from the bottom of my heart, from my soul, from everything that was within me, I appreciate you guys.
Amen.
I know the struggle.
Thank you.
Amen. You know, I know the struggle. I seen it. I feel it.
Yes.
But I love you. And I just want to say to you, keep pushing. Keep pushing.
Yes.
You say it all the time. God said, well, it don't matter what anybody else say, because God said it, that finishes it. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise God.
Talk to him. Come on, somebody, begin to speak to him. Come on, somebody. Where's your praise? Where's your worship at? Worship him. Come on, Shantaku. Child of God, where is your worship? Come on, Shantaku. Come on, somebody. Jesus. Come on, somebody. Lord. You gotta get in for yourself right now. I can't need you there. You gotta want it for yourself tonight. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
About a pastor chosen by God.
Yeah. Amen.
And the Lord said to him, arise and go to the streets which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judah for one called Saul, or Tarsus. For behold, he prayed, and had seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in to put his hand on him, that he might receive his sight.
Yeah.
Now we're going to backtrack a little bit in this. We're going to talk about who Paul was.
Amen.
You know, his name was Saul. He was an executioner. He was a person like in this day and time, somebody running the bad boys in the street. But he had leverage to go out and kill Christians. Not for nothing that he had done, just the mention of the name of Jesus Christ. That's what he was killing for. See, he was appointed to do that. He was an appointed executioner. Now, we're coming into this day and this age now where things are still going on. It might not seem like that, but you still got people trying to persecute, kill these pastors off. They don't want to recognize who the pastor is. And Pastor Roundtree, I got to say this to you. No matter who don't stand with you, God got you.
Amen.
See, I heard about you from my son, don't you? You got killed. I heard about you way before I even met you.
Amen.
He spoke highly of you. And that young man, you know what I'm saying? And you know he was doing his thing out there, but he was still trying to be the brother on the two.
Yeah.
So anytime you've got men coming in and talking about a pastor that's trying to do the right thing, and people started pulling him down and trying to tear him apart. This is something that Paul was doing.
Yeah.
You know, Paul, he was a highly respected man.
Yeah.
You know, and he was a dignitary. But he had letters to go out and kill.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And the thing of the world, he was killing innocent people.
Yeah.
And the day in this time and age, people are taking people's spirit and making people feel less than. If you don't know who you are, you better find out who you are.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? The only way you're going to do that, you're going to have to be under some covering.
Yes.
You got the best covering here.
Yeah.
The pastor is first lady. That's your covering.
Yes.
In the spiritual realm. You can't do this thing in the flesh. Don't get this twisted where you think you can just walk up in here and because I come and pay up for your tithes and stuff like this, that ain't nobody praying for you.
Amen.
You gotta have an intercessor, just like Jesus is an intercessor for us to God.
Amen.
Yeah. So is the pastor intercessor for you to God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. So nobody discouraged you. I don't care how much anointing you think somebody got. If you ain't in line and you with your pastor vision, stay up front of your pastor and go to your pastor and talk to your pastor about his view.
Amen.
I'm going to get back to this message.
Amen.
See, Paul got knocked down because God wanted to know why was he persecuting his saints.
Yeah.
You know, and these people he was killing were Christians.
Yeah.
You know, and but Paul was under the impression they didn't recognize Jesus. A lot of people don't want to recognize you if they don't know who you are.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But now, God knocked him down and blinded Paul.
Yeah.
Blinded Paul. Paul had to go and have somebody lay hands on him, which was Ananias.
Uh-huh.
And Ananias laid hands on Paul, received his sight. And after him receiving his sight, the conversion started taking place. It's ground moving. It's small steps at a time.
Uh-huh.
Small. Once you get converted, you have to put some work in.
Yes.
You have to put some work in. You have to have a prayer life.
Yes.
You have to have a study life.
Yes.
You have to have somebody guide you through this walk.
Yes.
And don't think you can walk this walk by yourself.
Amen.
Because it ain't going to happen.
Amen.
I don't care how you ain't doing the wrong thing.
Yes.
What you used to do, you ain't doing that no more. Don't get this twisted.
Yes.
Don't get this twisted.
Yes.
Because this thing here needs a cover.
Oh,
this thing here needs a cover. And don't let nobody come in your life telling you, oh, that's what he said. That ain't what I do. Yeah, you know what I'm doing. The pastor said, I got to have faith.
Yes.
I got to have some faith. I got to have some substance. Oh,
you
know. Stand with something. See, because you stand, the pastor stands.
Yes.
See, if he's chosen by God,
yes.
You know you're going to stand because God has already gave him a vision to stand. But he's trying to put that vision in you to help you grow as well as him to grow.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You already see he's suffering because you've seen where he came from.
Yeah,
the way he's at now.
Praise
just
God.
Just imagine where he's going.
Praise God.
So if you're backing, you'll be right.
Praise God.
You can sit and say, well, that's the pastor. He got to do that. No, he got to do this. Y'all got to do
that. Amen.
So, y'all the sheep in his flock.
Yeah.
You the shepherd of his flock.
Yeah.
You know? And you got to understand who you are standing behind.
Yeah.
I keep saying understanding because it's easy to say, I know the pastor. God's going to pray for you, he's going to give me a prophetic word. You're going to tell me something to make me feel better. What about the pastor when he get down?
Amen. Somebody got to get a pastor prophet to do it.
Amen.
Because he get burned down. He just want to get burned down.
Yes.
And like right now, this season right now, he's going through. But he's going to get through.
Yes, he is.
Because he got God in
his
life.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, and he is.
This is what happened to Paul. You know, he made it through the blindness by seeking the Holy Ghost. You know, he had to go and get Ananias to touch him. And he went his way, and then the Holy Ghost came upon him. And everybody talked about how much of this Bible Paul has written, 3/4 of his Bible. But before Paul, the people don't talk about Saul. They always talk about Paul.
Yeah.
See, you have to come from somewhere to get to somewhere. Yeah. See, he came from somewhere. Now God is taking him to another level where he is a man of God. He's going against the old way. His old way was to condemn people. Then he was, once he was converted, his way became where he wanted the right to be right because of the lack of knowledge, the lack of understanding of what this world is saying. If I don't know who's who in this world, who's who in these churches, I'll be thrown.
Yes,
I'll be thrown. And the spirit of the storm, anything you ask God, in the name of Jesus, ask God. Ask God. See, and when he gave Saul his vision, Saul got on his job. Saul and then Peter and all the boys start coming to Saul and start helping him take care of the message. And we're called to carry a message. We're called to carry this message of Christ.
Amen. You know?
And we're called to support, you know. The pastor is chosen.
Yeah,
and got to follow. We can't leave the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we want to get out in front of the pastor and think we know more than the pastor. Stop. Wait a minute. It don't even work.
Amen.
Because God can give you the vision.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
This thing is about the vision. See, when God chose him because he gave him a vision, a specific vision, to do some things, specific things to do.
Right.
You know, he know what to do. I don't know what to do. If I ain't gonna be part of the kingdom, I need to get out of this world. Because it's him. Now he got to close his Bible, he got to go pray for me, pray for himself, but he don't want to get off track of what he's doing. You know. And the key. His anointing, pressing on toward the mark. You know, how would I say this? I'm going to say it the way God gave it to me and shout out the Holy Ghost and use you in the street. Now, I just don't want to be up here lip syncing and making it sound good.
Uh-huh.
You know, in the Bible, you know, sometimes we're going to suffer some perilous things, you know, to suffer. This is where I'm at right now. The other way is just what the suffering. After the conversion came, then the suffering started happening because wanting to do the right thing is not able to do the right thing because of your suffering. You know, you get caught up. You miss the mark sometimes because you overlook what you're going through. For God, instead of, and then you take the personal, you put God's stuff on the back burner, and then you put your personal life on the front burner. And you call it your personal life, you're going to miss the mark. See, and missing the mark means, I don't mean by completely jumping out of the hand of God, and standing in the will of God, but understanding that once you're converted, and what like the pastor has been converted and been chosen, he needs a lot of people. Over these last 3 days, I talked about this, you know what I'm saying, because I get thrown. When we don't understand what we have out here.
Yeah.
You know, y'all feel the church on Sunday.
Yeah.
Y'all know you got a good pastor.
Yeah.
Y'all know where you came from.
Yeah.
Y'all know what he's fighting. He's fighting a lot of demons out here in the ministry that don't want him to succeed.
Amen.
He's fighting. He might not say that, but he's fighting. And once he start letting them demons be what they are behind him, behind you, under your feet, you're going to go where God got you going. You're going to go where God taking you somewhere. God's taking you somewhere. Just like he did Paul. Now look at Paul. He took Paul from killing Christians to save a life.
Amen.
He started saving lives. He from killing the Lord. Now he wants everybody to get the word.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody to get the word. He's teaching the word. He's showing you how to understand the word. And he wanted everybody to stay on track. You know, and once he got converted, God started aligning in two, sending them out in two, you know. And I'm a little,
I'm a little shaken right now with this word. I'm a little shaken right now.
Go ahead.
I understand. I understand this. This. And I can't put enough emphasis on this. The vision. The vision that has been given to the gospel right now. A lot of young men, a lot of young black men is going to be saved through this year.
Amen.
Praise God.
More than we can realize, a lot of.
Amen. Praise God.
A lot. And you can see the numbers. I can see it. Yeah. And a lot of young black men, he's going to give us what a lot of us never had. That's hope. That's important. Yeah. Somebody can help change this generation because we got a generation now that is killing each other off.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This is what was happening back in the old days. Everybody was doing what they wanted to do, what they wanted to do, and how they wanted to do. We have to understand, we need to stay on the road, stay on the thing focused on what God has got us to do.
Amen.
We come in the house of God. Make sure you come in the house of God for the right reason.
Yeah, so
we ain't coming here to make a pastor stumble. We coming here to 30,000 to build a pastor.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? He can take the little bit that he has, which he has been doing, and prosper. God will prosper. God fed 5,000. Look what God can do for him.
Amen.
Amen.
Understand this.
Amen.
You know, me and my wife start adding to this ministry because of who he was.
Praise God.
Mm-hmm. I know who he is. He's humble. He's kind. He's gentle. And anytime you meet him, he's going to go,
amen.
You know what I'm saying? And, please, Lord, help me, Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Praise God. Help me, Holy Ghost. You know, I've been telling my wife, I can't believe nobody was here to support the pastor. But now I see some memories here. And now, the members that's here, I seen two or three women that was here, but the members that are here right now, if y'all pass this word on that your pastor is doing the right things and going through the right things and God is going to bless the pastor, watch out everybody want to come because they were part of what he's going to be giving.
Amen.
He's going to be giving something great. And,
Jesus.
The word tells us, we be obedient with the NOB. We shall receive the life.
That's right.
We shall receive the life.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I want to take this back, get back cut off. I want to get back on Paul.
Yes.
Paul. That's the book. People didn't realize that he was called from the time before when he was still in prison. He was already called. Mm-hmm. What he had to go through,
yeah,
to get to where he needed to be.
Yes. Yes.
You know, and what he needed to do was be blind.
Yeah. Yes.
To be blind by God. But he could understand that he wasn't supposed to be killing people, physically killing them. He was killing their spirit also.
Yes.
And God stepped in.
Mm-hmm.
God stepped in. Paul started doing church work. Not ministry, started doing church work.
Mm-hmm.
Because now he was already educated. He was already everything he needed to be.
Amen.
Before it's coming to, excuse me, we're going to get there in a minute. Don't get involved with me. Just let me get these things together.
Amen.
I got to repeat it out.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? But I didn't give you the word. And I know I ain't supposed to be playing with this word like this.
Yes.
Let me read this. And Ananias had in a vision. A man named Ananias come in and put his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Then Ananias answered the Lord, I have heard by many others of this man how much evil he has done to the saints at Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priest to bind all that call on thy name. You know, if you call the name of Jesus, he had the authority to kill you, bind you up, and take you to prison. But the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he has chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles, the kings, and the children of Israel. And like I was just saying, Pastor Roundtree is in that same category. Where a lot of people are going to get saved through Pastor Roundtree.
Amen.
you. I got to have a conversation with you.
Yes,
you got to have that and tell them what you want. You have to tell them. You're the head.
Yes.
You head. You got a marriage with God. You're the head. Understand this. I know you know who you are. I know you know you're Pastor Round Tree, anointed the prophet, and a prophet, and a prophet. And got a prophetic word for me. Use that prophetic anointing God got in your life to set these crooked people straight. You know, and I'm not calling them evil. I'm just saying they know you gonna give them to them. You gonna give them to them. I tell the pastor I'm gonna do something. Get them people in line. Cause that's their blood on you.
Amen.
These people's blood is on you. Everybody sitting here running your word, their blood is on your hands.
Yes, Lord.
Regardless of how they feel, how they take it. You know blood wrong. You from the street. Don't come in here and get so sanctified you forget what blood wrong is. Yeah. Because God can give it to you. God can give you this thing like this. God can give you this thing through trial and error.
Amen.
He gave you. Ain't no other leaders in your church but you.
Yeah.
In your way.
That's right.
Amen.
You gotta start sitting people down. And tell them to get out your way.
Amen.
Don't you let nobody hand over this ministry to God
again. Amen.
I can't help you doing it.
Amen.
Amen. God got somebody else to do
it. Amen.
Amen. Stop. Get man, pull your coat off, man, and stand up and tell them people to get out your way.
That's right.
Because if you don't stop that spirit from trying to help you, watch what God do for you.
Amen.
See, you got to go to God.
Yes.
See, Paul had to go to God.
Yes.
You know, Paul was with, he was protecting God, but he had Jesus in him. He didn't want to recognize Jesus, just like a lot of people want to recognize Jesus. They want to recognize everything else but you. See, because they think they don't learn to read his word. A lot of them think they don't read some word. They got some word. But the reading of his word is not anointed in the life. Because the manifestation haven't came through you.
Amen.
Amen. Being a guide and to help people get to the other side because they see them under your anointing in your ministry.
Praise God.
The ministry that God has given you, you and God ministry. I don't want it to get it wrong for people say you ain't got no ministry. I want to tell you, the anointing ministry that God has given you. He gave us to you.
Lord.
He gave you the vision. See, this thing is about the vision.
Yes.
This thing is about the vision. Last year this time you didn't have a church building. Somebody came and brought the church in your house.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
ain't
you.
No man just did that out of coincidence.
Yes.
They did that because of the favor
that's
on your
life.
The favor that's on your life. Anything you like it, you're supposed to go straight to God in the name of Jesus.
Oh,
Lord. You ain't supposed to be using nothing nobody got. You're supposed to ask God about it.
Amen.
You can walk and command things that you don't even understand what you need to command.
Lord.
You need to get out of that spirit where people. You feel like you need people.
Amen.
You don't need nobody. You the head. Let them do that. Let him work on AC. Let him work on AC. That's his job. If he can't repent, he won't work in letting. That's my point.
Amen.
Watch what God got you doing. My new thing, let somebody else handle it.
Yeah.
Let somebody else handle it. Let somebody else handle it. You don't got the word for the week. The pastor don't preach to you 2 nights a week.
Yeah.
2 nights ago, he don't preach prophetic things when they have from you. If it happens, don't get discouraged, because I'm not picking on you. I got to tell you. This is a celebration for you.
Yeah.
If nobody else came to the building today,
this
ain't for celebrating for other people, this is a celebration between you and God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
See, because God can't give you nothing until you have a celebration. Then when I first came the other night, I read about the wedding. Didn't nobody come to the wedding when I got the people out the street.
That's right.
When I got people off the street.
Yeah.
Finally. Bid them come. See, God gonna take the people that's with you. They don't want to walk with you. And besides them, that's the round truth. You as a man of God.
Yes, yes.
You're a man that God has called.
Some are called.
But you're chosen.
Amen.
Yeah.
You're chosen, though. You're chosen, though. Family. The dog, the cat,
okay.
Anything don't want to walk with you.
have your way.
I got to give this to you the way God gave it to me. Because I tried to go in this word, I came about Paul, about the conversion of Paul, how he was locked down for doing what he thought was right. See, sometimes we can do what we think is right, and it's wrong. It's wrong. See, we got to do what God said to do. If we're walking in the calling of God, we got to do what God said, because he called us, he ordained us to do it. See, and let me tell you something else. Once God done took some out of your hand, once he done took some out of your hand, whatever God done took out of your hand, leave it out of your hand.
Amen. Amen.
Don't prove no more. Your weapon is your mouth.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. And anointing that crown that's on your head. That's your
right.
weapon.
Amen.
That's your weapon.
Amen.
You can speak words to people and they'll bow. But you got to know that here. You got a prophetic word for everybody in here. And it's true. But for you, you know how to say it. Prophesize to the world. Yeah, prophesize to the world. And be sincere about prophetic words. Know that. The church got people in here who want to take your church over. But they can't.
Amen.
They don't even understand the anointing that they're messing with.
Nah.
And you got a glorified sin beside you.
Amen.
Y'all like this. Y'all like this.
That's right.
No matter what past y'all came from, the thing of you is God has joined y'all.
That's right. Yeah.
Understand what God joined you for. He didn't join you for what y'all been through. He joined you for the anointing that he put in your life.
Amen.
That's right. Nobody gets nowhere. See, you got a mate. She just like you.
Yes.
What you like it is, she gonna speak on it.
Now,
when she speak to you, take it, man. Take it for gold. Because she won't do nothing to hurt you because of the simple fact you're in the house with her.
Thank God.
She knows if you bless, she bless.
Yes. Amen.
And you bring everything. Well, my man, look at that. Nobody gonna worry about that. Let him look. At least somebody can have something you that want what you got.
Amen.
Worry about the wrong thing. Worry about what people say. What people are doing. Keep
my Jesus.
Keep
this thing.
Don't worry about nobody. Don't worry about you ain't in the streets no more. Quit trying to prove a point.
That's right. Amen.
You prove a point.
Amen.
You prove a point. You prove a point and you anointed.
That's it. Amen.
You, now, I'm sitting up here, my minister. You tell me what proving point over the anointed.
Now.
You can call those things which they are not, as if they were.
That's good, sir.
You the head. You the head, Pastor. You the head.
Yes, sir.
I know you call shots around you, but the shots you call them, you better call them a little bit more sturdy and tell people that they are. You want to set this church up.
Amen.
It's your feet.
Amen.
Your wife's feet, your feet. It's your house. God has given you a house to protect.
Amen.
You protect when you got in the street, you protect everything out there.
Amen.
Amen.
They say you were the wilder out there. Be more stern in here. And then God ain't gonna forgive. God ain't gonna get mad with you if you be more strict in here.
Amen.
Because if you I don't care. I don't care. Y'all might not tell me to come back and open ain't gonna be I got to talk straight to you. I got to speak straight to you. I was studying this word. Maybe at another time. But at this time right here, Pastor, this is about you. You're chosen.
Amen.
You're chosen. And you're chosen and you're called. You're anointed. You're blessed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Every time somebody comes up against you, they fall.
Yes.
Yes.
They fall. Sad to say. Sad to say. And if they mistreat her,
that's it.
And that they heard you about mistreating her, they gonna fall.
Yes.
Right.
My
God.
Call Jesus. She's a prophet. You got the prophetic anointing.
Amen.
Y'all supposed to be walking. So you see, sometimes my wife thinks she'll tell you. I'm being real about this, man. I have to be real about what I have to deal with because I've been so used to, hey, you don't tell me what to do.
Yeah,
I will pay. That ain't what this is about. Coming in the house of God, this ain't what this is about. She got a warning on her life. I know she got a warning on her life.
Very good, Lord.
I tell her, Lord, I treat her the wrong way. I'll miss what God got for me because it's about a circle. It's not a square. It's a circle. It's not a square. But I can't put that circle into this.
Yeah,
I got to keep that circle.
And then I got to let God see the ceiling. That's something.
Oh, yes.
See, because God had everything around the circle. He got there. When he got this thing so designed for you, you got to do it one more time.
Amen.
Yes. You know, you're looking at who saying this and who talking about you, who trying to steal your number, that's still.
Yeah.
See, the number going on today is still.
Jesus. Yeah.
Ah, you gotta say that.
Now,
ah.
You said something.
You correct me if I'm wrong.
Amen.
See, you ain't just walking to this thing full of the Holy Ghost. You walk in this thing with some child down in the street.
Yes.
And you
have
to go out and before you got
that. Yes. Amen.
You're doing a lot.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And it's harvest time. Seeds been planted, it's harvest time.
Right. Yes.
It's been growing. If you don't see what's going on in your life, you don't see what's going on, don't look at the small things that happen.
Yes.
Look at the big picture.
Yes.
Yes. God giving you everything you ever wanted to do.
Yes.
But you got to recognize the word to protect.
Yes.
Just like in the street, you got to protect yourself. Protect the house of God.
Amen.
Don't let them hoodlums come up here with them hoodlums down the tube and telling you, take it over your service.
That's right. That's right.
They got to go through her.
Lord. Amen.
She got to come to you.
Yes.
Yes. Lord.
She had to go in your church.
Yes.
Lord.
Right.
Lord.
If you let somebody else do that, you understand, out of order.
Amen.
And everything you her background. She don't look over at Jeff Rowe for no support. She look at Pastor Ryan.
Amen.
When you go home and sit at the dinner table, she looking for love to take at you.
Oh, Lord. I'm telling you.
And she looking for support. Support your wife like the Lord before.
Amen.
And watch when you unify what God do. If the children out of order, give them your own.
Yes.
Don't talk about this my other baby mama child. Get them in order.
Yes.
Get them in order.
Right.
Get them in order.
Oh.
Because that right there, she's depressed. She's depressed.
Yes.
You depressed.
Amen. Amen.
Play with it if you want.
Now,
you say, I love my son, but he ain't going to disrespect her.
Amen.
It ain't going
to happen.
My mom ain't going to disrespect her.
Amen.
I love my mom to death.
Amen.
Ain't going to be in my room, but I'm going to let my mom know, hey, that's my wife.
Amen.
That's right.
Do it again, now I'm going to tell you how it is.
Okay.
Amen.
That's all.
If I let you disrespect her, you disrespect me.
That's right.
You can go. Scratch your head. You can be sleeping. Well, I'm trying to give you what God puts in me.
Amen.
Identify you. Identify you because the word written, the little bit that you have, take it.
Yes.
And do the best you can with it.
Yes.
And God wants it.
Yes.
He told you about the widow. He told you about the widow from the flower. Yes. He told you about that little seed. It was blessed. And this conference is to bless you.
Amen.
See, the enemy tried to give it over yesterday. The enemy tried to give it over yesterday with the delay from you being here. The pastor signed me waiting on you to get
that.
You want to respect the man in the house. But the Holy Spirit said, go on because you curse. Because they tried to heal me. They tried to heal me. You know, Lucifer.
Yes.
Lucifer, full-footed Lucifer.
Yes.
That's all you put that spirit in people that in your church, not to get you where you need to be. Out in the world, you got to go. You can't get the pastor where you need
to
be. Ain't nothing else that important.
Yeah, that's right.
If you run up in this house, you're a man or woman of God. You better eat them.
Right.
I'm telling you, this is my mom. And you can go over there and tell Lucifer what I'm saying. Because I'm for bad to fight.
All right.
I come to fight.
Amen.
I have to fight. Because of my faith.
Yes.
I got to protect this Holy Ghost that's in me.
Yes.
I got to protect this.
Yes.
I got to protect my wife.
Yes.
You don't want to help my wife. You don't want to help me.
Yes.
Amen.
That's the price when you help my wife. That's the price when you help me. What the hell is it about?
God.
But I need somebody like that for God. Man, you talk about me sitting in my CU. I'm telling you this. And man to man, in the name of Jesus, through the Holy Ghost, because I don't sit around and just come and talk to people like this.
Amen.
And people that know me know I tell them straight up, hey man, I ain't feeling that today.
Amen.
But I'm telling you what the Holy Ghost has given me. It's given me to tell you, to tell the demons to get back. Only you can get to the Lord.
Amen.
Even when they look up. See, the devil knows when he can play an out of play.
Amen.
He gonna play what you let him play.
Amen.
You give him a crack, ain't gonna eat with nobody. You know who's really seeking God. The ones that's really seeking God, the ones that's important y'all, is keeping things real. I ain't talking about no cover up here. Put this over there and it's happening. We're saying it to me.
Amen.
Real. Put it on the table.
Yeah.
Put it on the table that you see it for yourself. You have to sift. You have to, see, we were sifted.
Right.
Before God called you, he sifted you.
Yes, yes, yes.
He tried you.
Amen.
A lot of people say God tried you, but you was tried out in the streets to see if you're going to be a hold of that person.
Yes.
The devil tried to kill you. And right now today, the devil will make you pick up a pistol and put it in your pocket. He's still trying to take you out.
Yes.
In fact, he know your bad.
Yes.
He know your bad.
Yes, God.
You know your bad.
Amen.
You ain't got to prove no point to nobody.
Yeah.
If you got a cousin over here, three nieces over here, and all of them got churches, and they over there playing games, they're going to church them play. Your assignment is to help these young kids. You look at them, who's in your ministry. You ain't got no whole lot of people in your ministry. You got some older people, but you ain't got that many. You got babies in your ministry.
All right.
And they looking at you.
Amen.
They looking at you.
Amen.
And one of these jokers, I'm going to say jokers. One of these jokers get out of line, them children see that.
Amen.
You got children in your house. Somebody, one of them little children watch everything you do.
Amen.
And then they mimic. Now, a child see the authority that you have. I didn't say go there and be authoritarian and say, hey, I got a whip, so go do this.
Yeah.
I said, Mark, Democrats, shoot with the heart. You got to try the spirit by the spirit.
Yes.
All these spirits ain't with you.
Yeah.
And when you go to put people that ain't with you in position, you go to your church, you're giving them too much power.
Yeah.
You're taking the power out of your white man. Your wife don't hurt her. Ain't no other. No other. No other. Come on. Do the hand. She's ready to race.
Yes.
Look at Paul. He's got converted. He had to go to the disciples. See, they're going to start coming to him. These are the ones that walk to you. And you've been blessed with the members. They're going to come in and encourage you to continue to go. Because this fight ain't starting.
Yes.
Oh. You need to get some choices. You got two left. You got two left. So what you, give them what you require.
Yes.
What you require. I got ways. I got things. I don't always stand. I don't always talk properly. I get down with you. You in the trenches. I get in the trenches with you.
That's right.
Because I ain't gonna let you run over me. See, you have to put the devil under your feet.
That's right.
See, everybody wanna talk about what Paul said. Paul said, if you're in Rome, act like you're Rome.
Yes.
If you're gonna act like you're Rome, get out of Rome.
Yes. Yes.
So if they come to your church acting out of order, and they don't want to get in order, you know the procedure. You know the procedure. You know the procedure. You need to take one, you can go to them, if they don't listen to you, get a witness. If they don't listen to you, you know what to do. Put them out there. See, the worst thing where the devil wants to be done is exposed.
Yes.
You get in the yard. God. He tricked Adam and Eve, but he used Eve. Because Eve thought she was doing the right thing. And Adam was sitting right there with him. He was right there with him. He wouldn't say that. He didn't want her to tell the truth. And then he tried to hide from God. See, God knows all. God knows all.
Amen.
God referred you from one thing to another. front to another, and the level, different levels, different devils.
Yes.
The stronger you get, the stronger these devils get.
Amen.
They get stronger. They read and study this word. They read and study this word, they know with us. Because you teach them. You teach them. But you, I don't care. You can look around, cut your eyes off. I call the truth for the view because I didn't come here to play. I came here to help this church to go where you got to go. And you know, and God was already, God was already laid the foundation. The foundation is God equipped you. You're equipped. You're equipped better than just 40 years ministers for a minute. In the ministry of 40 years. Everything you don't learn in your ministry.
Yes.
You're stressing. stressing. You're stressing. You're stressing. You're getting blessed. You're getting blessed. You can't enjoy your blessing. You're stressing so much. The burden of the burden. You got millions in here to fix everything in this building before you do your ass. You got to trust. Yeah. See, it's not just them. See, they play. People play on you. They play on you.
Amen.
And when you look at the conversion of Paul didn't play that. Paul gave an assignment.
That's right.
Assignment. This is what we need. It's not a debate. It's not a debate. If you laboring every night, going before God, laying before God, praying and asking God for anointing and blessing on that child, when they come to you and take that child, ain't gonna be able to pray about that child.
Yes.
It's taking away. Because you're putting attention. There'll always be the empty picture.
Amen.
God keep filling you and filling you and filling you, and you keep getting burned down. You're a full fountain. With nothing but life coming out of you. Understand what's coming out of you. Understand who all you're touching.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You don't even see the people that you're really touching. You see the kind of that you think you want to touch.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's what I'm doing. You got people that's out there in the world wanting to be with you. You got somebody that want to see you back out there. Jeez. But they, that ain't going to happen.
No, mm-hmm.
That ain't happening. But God will call you. You'll call your children enough. Your chosen. Your chosen. They can play with you. But you know you need to be real with
them.
And get this in order. Them children supposed to support you. They supposed to support you no matter what. And they don't even know walk through the door. You've seen them. It's a burden lifted and walking. When you don't see no memo, that's something else you got to worry about. They really with me. You ain't open to say that, but you feel it.
Yes.
Feel it. This part of God's love, you don't do that enough. Everything you need before you get depressed, before you go trying to figure out how you're going to make it out, in the name of Jesus, ask God.
Amen.
No, you know what to do. Make a petition.
Yeah.
You need a petition for everything that you need. You need a petition for something. Everybody else can be saved. You win so you save yourself. God will reward you for your faith. You got to petition God for something yourself. You got to petition for you. Your family. Because if you and your family good, everybody in the church will be good. It trickles downhill.
Yes.
The blood stained down. We got about to heal. The blood ran down.
Yes.
And look at, we wasn't even entitled to this. We was grafted into this. And graftation comes from you in your church. You got everything you need. You got singer, you got musician. God will give you everything you need. Everything you need. No lacking. Your head don't been anointed. The 23rd song, your wife in the red.
Jesus.
Go on there, look at the majestic that's in that 23rd song. The anointing. The provision. The blessing.
Amen.
And he's telling you what he's going to do for your enemy. And if you have no enemy, you have a problem. If everybody like you, you'll be a problem.
That's right.
Yeah. You've got to have some enemies where God can do some things in your life. Let your enemies know he's in you.
That's right. That's
show right. Your man ain't got no enemies. I'm going to show you a door ain't doing something.
That's right.
Amen. All right.
He done gave you something to convert your enemies over.
Yes. That's good.
You do the conversion. Don't let them convert you.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Amen.
You fight. Don't blow. You're a great box in the spiritual world. In the spiritual realm, you know the word, you hear the word, you practice the word, you preach the word, you speak the word. On your life. You don't need all the people to come over and go to the church. You can do that. Your wife right there.
Filled with the Holy Ghost in your life to help bless you.
Come on.
Yes.
Yes.
that will bless you, that will bless you, because I'm telling you about my son. That's how I heard about you, through my son.
Yes.
And he ain't the only one that speak highly of you. And they crazy about you.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
See, and you know they got their own lifestyle that they live and they thugging and stuff like this. But people will tell you, I don't want to use that thug money. Show me a face of thug or money.
Come on now.
That's the Lord, just running, keep moving.
That's right.
Amen. You praying over the money. If you praying over the money, the money will set in.
That's right. That's right.
You going like it because you're gonna stay in the custom.
Yes. Yes.
Just old people, old tradition, the old people custom, what they take. Boy, that money, that dirty money. Okay, it might be dirty, but I'm going to use it. It ain't the money. Don't get the game twisted. It ain't the money. It's the people spending the money.
Amen.
It's your intentions with the money.
That's right.
See, that's how Ananias and all of them got killed. Uh-huh. That on God, brother. Because God gave it to them.
Yeah.
When they sold somebody, they told them they don't get money, to God, he did.
That's right.
So, you know what I'm saying? It's hard. Because you make it hard.
That's right.
It ain't fair. If being a man of God,
it will never be fair.
But God gave us all the things, but we don't want to put our two cents in it and try to fix it and make it better.
Right.
It ain't gonna never be perfect.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna never be perfect. Don't let nobody tell you it's gonna be perfect. That thing ain't gonna never be perfect. This thing gonna be what it is. Uh-huh. I don't care who you is.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are. I'm straight. I studied this word. I tried to study the word to come bring this word. But God told me to come to it.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know what I want.
Praise God.
You know what you I don't even have to say no more. You know if I'm telling the truth or not.
Praise God.
Amen.
You know. God has visited you several times about what I'm telling you. Several times. And I wasn't even there. He done did it too several times. About this thing. You're going to have a lot of people stop doing it. Because they stop. You keep pressing on. And watch the dignitary that God will do. Real.
Yes.
Real. I'm like crazy. First time I went to the church, I was in the schoolhouse. I said, I'm real about what I do. I said, I'm just about 3 months out of everybody. And still ready to go somewhere.
Yeah.
I said, she'll tell you, I don't believe about around 3. And I said, you're about everybody in the church. You come on right the back of the church. And I'm prophesying. And we're on point.
Yes,
sir. We're on point. See, the thing of real, some people prophesy a lot.
Yes.
Prophesying.
Yes.
And see, when you got people out here on the streets giving you as much respect as people in the church giving you,
that's right.
Telling you your value.
Yes, God.
The devil trying to keep you twisted. And God got you. God got you. He can't knock that God in
you. No.
See, but he's throwing some in a dagger.
Yes.
You put daggers around you to make you think that this ain't gonna happen when it's gonna happen. Yeah. You don't know anything gonna happen to you. You know it was coming, but you know how soon. Look at that. Now you got a building, now you got a place that you can hold you can put people in your life and help them.
Yeah.
You, only you. You got to speak this thing.
Yeah.
Speak and decree this thing, man. You got. I came in here, last time we go here, you had prayer boys walking around the church room.
Yeah.
They praying, they set the atmosphere for you. You ain't had no people in here praying, they was praying.
Yeah.
They was petitioning God. So now, therefore, you got some people to petition God to get what you need to do. You got people that will help you. Listen, I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna drop this. Because I done told you what God told me to tell you.
Amen.
Now you can receive that. Or you can let them play with you continue. And thank God for giving for this.
I love you. I don't know how to talk to him. I just like my own son. The buster and all of this. And Kills even come to my hospital. He talks about both of y'all and Joe. I can't help but love you. I love you like my own son. There's nothing in this world that I would not do for you.
Praise God.
I tell you all the time. Call for you. That's mother's love.
Yes.
I'm not here to hinder anybody. I'm not here to try to take a position. I'm not playing. God has assigned you guys to us.
Amen.
I'm going to hold up and look back down to what God has told me to do. If they look wrong, I ain't going to break down. I can't speak on the right now because I don't like to say something. God is doing something different. He's asking for you once this year for more stuff.
Yes.
It's time, y'all. Come up.
Yes.
Come out. And walk in.
Amen.
Trust in the
process.
The mantle is on you.
Yes.
It's no more being afraid. The process is short. The mantle is on you.
Thank you.
show your leaders that you appreciate them.
Amen.
Take the time out sometimes, take them out to lunch. You know, it ain't always about money. Give them a call. How you doing? Always get to be on Sunday or Wednesday night. If I'm going to ask how, I'll be doing the week to check on food. But that's what I do. I would see them on Facebook. I hear about them. I don't have to be on their legs for the Lord. It's one of the different come out on Facebook, all this clothes, events, spiritual, and that's it. So I thank God for that.
Yeah. No, man.
18 years. It ain't been easy.
No, ain't.
What God? So, the last presentation we would like to give.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wipe that clean, because God said he throwed our sins in the well.
He
forgiven. So why are we so fearful now? What will God do? He raised me up. He can do the same thing he did for me.
Amen.
For
praise
me.
God.
Amen. What people do to me now, I ain't saying.
Thank you.
Tough skin.
Amen.
I'm going to
on behalf of the Ark, Riverview, and these two beautiful people, we want to present you with this love offering.
Yes.
And we just want to tell you thank you. And we're here to hold up your shoulders, your hands, whatever you need. We're there for you. You're not forgotten. We love you, and we're here.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I just want to let you know that the Spirit of the Lord was dealing with me, and God was telling me that He's pleased with you for being obedient.
Yeah.
And many people have overlooked you because they don't know what lies on the inside of you.
Amen.
And there is a prophetic side. You have so much sharp discernment. And the reason why it was so hard for you to flow from the book, because there's a prophetic flow in you. And how God has created you is to eat the word. Eat the word. Let you eat it and digest it. And just flow. So it was, you were doing everything right. God is pleased with you. And God says, continue to keep going. He said, no longer will you be stagnated. No longer will you be held up. He said, it's your season. It's your time to come forth in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everything that's locked up on the inside of you has to come forth.
Yeah.
And we thank God for Mama Helen being there to push you. We thank God for her knowing what lies on the inside of you, because everybody can't see that. And I thank God for you being man enough. It takes a real man not to quench a woman of God.
Yes.
And let her flourish.
Yes.
Because it's power when there's two in agreement.
Amen.
And I just want to let you know, continue to flow. Continue to let God use you and trust Him. It wasn't for you to figure it out. It was for you to flow. Even though you couldn't figure it out, I was so happy that you just flow and let Him use you how He used you. It's not your job to be like nobody else, but to be who He created you to be.
Amen.
Because there's so much on the inside of you. God is going to use you to prophesy. It's not about eloquence, like the pastor talking about the eloquence of speaking. It's not about eloquent speaking. It's not about being like anybody else but you. Because it's a lot, you know. You have street smarts, but not only do you have street smarts, you are so firm and so strong in the spirit. And you just need to stand in who you are.
Amen.
And that's the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Come on, you can take your seat. Amen. I'm not going to hold you long. LaShawn. Amen. Come on, y'all give LaShawn a hand as she comes. Amen. It's a token of love.
Amen.
Mother Helen. First, let me start off by saying I appreciate you all. Amen. One thing I will tell y'all is I love my church. Glory to God. I'm going to tell y'all the best thing about me is I know I'm called to do this. Amen. Other people think I'm crazy because they close to me. See, everybody in the church ain't close to me. So they pastor, but the people that's close to me, they get to see the me that's not. They know what I'm like when I'm drinking Kool-Aid, watching football, hanging out with Papa. See, they get to see the humanity side of me. Amen. But you guys get to see the divinity all the time. Amen. But I'm a man. Amen. And one thing I do know in the midst of everything I've been through in my life, that I'm called to do this.
Amen.
I don't care what I go through in my life, I'm going to continue to walk in purpose. Amen. But one thing, he said a lot of great stuff tonight. And if you know the word of God, the Bible says that the older shall guide or lead the younger. That's what the Bible say. That's how it's supposed to be done. I was telling y'all this morning how I was talking to the children And I was telling them some things this morning, and glory to God, not to be mad, amen, or not to be upset with them, but it's things that we must teach them, because the older shall guide what? The younger. It's our job, amen, it's our job. But I do want to say thank you, and I truly, I receive every word, not just on tonight, but the first two nights. I said this earlier too, that I love to receive from other men and women of God. I don't think that it's all about me, and you know, I really like sitting at the feet of other men and women of God. And truth be told, I learned that from Pastor Zach. I would be with him, and we'll be traveling to different conferences and different places, and he had a pen, he had a piece of paper, and he was richer. He had more than probably half the men that was sitting where he was, but he was the only one jotting down everything that was being said. He was in tune, and those are some of the traits that I picked up from him. If he can do it, surely I can. You know, so I really appreciate you guys. And you know, in this season of my life, I know who with me and I know who not with me. Glory to God. I know it's like Jesus said, you say you love me, but your heart is far from me. Your heart proves to me where you are. Glory, not just what you say. Glory to God. So I want you guys to know that I do appreciate each and every one of you. Amen. In this room. And yes, the road gets tough, but we're not going to quit. We're not going to give up. We started in a hotel with me, Brianna, a baby C, baby, and Raya. I don't know if Lexi was here yet. I think she was about to come. Oh, Raquel was still in your tummy, right? Glory to God. And I was fresh out of work release about 2 or 3 weeks. Glory to God. I'm for real. I'm serious. But it's what the Lord told me to do. Nobody gave me the name of this church, Brianna. I used to tell you, I used to be saying, the church going to be named this, the church going to be named that. Oh, I got a new name today. The Holy Ghost said, the Ark.
Yeah.
When I came out of that place, I said, the Holy Ghost says, the Ark. It's going to be the Ark. It ain't going to be nothing else but the Ark. Glory to God. So I hear people saying other stuff and changing to this and all that. No, the Holy Ghost ain't tell me to do that. The Holy Ghost said, it's the Ark. Glory to God. It's a safe place. Glory to God. And it is a place where the anointing is. Glory to God. He talked a lot about the Ark when he was preaching. Glory to God. The Ark is where the presence of God was. If you want to know one thing about me, I got the presence. God.
Amen.
I don't boast about it. I don't brag about it. But that's something God has given me since I was a baby Christian. I can see stuff. I can hear stuff. It's just a gift. Everybody say it's a gift.
Yeah.
Everybody in this room have a gift. But the thing about the gift is you can't abuse it.
Amen.
Because I can see something in you. I can't get $50 out of you. You know what I mean? Glory to God. Because I know God will heal you. If I pray for you, I can't use that for manipulation. But God has given us gifts for reason. Paul said, I wish that you were all prophesy. All should prophesy. Why? Because it edifies and lifts up the body of Christ. People come through those doors, they're not lifted up. Some of them had, they was catching a lot of trouble just trying to get to the house of God. Amen. They were running late, not because of them. The children didn't want to get up. They didn't want to put on their clothes this morning. You know how when you have kids, sometimes they just feel like they want to trip. And you be like, well, you tripping today? I'm going to trip too, right along with you. Get up and get out there. But then, you know
that's how it be. So
we different things. Amen. And we all come in with different stuff. I know. Amen. Glory to God. I'm just getting the preliminaries out the way. She think I forgot. I ain't forget. But I was just saying, you know, that I appreciate you all. And I'm going to pray. Glory to God. I'm going to pray. This, I know that I am. In this season of my life, I'm even sharper as a prophet than I ever been. I can't explain it. The other day, when I prophesied to that man, the Lord told me to prophesy. I just did, glory to God. It's like it was something that the Lord desired for me to do. Amen. It was something that needed to be said. That he was out there talking to Raymond, and he said, man, you don't know what you just said to me. You know, but he was like, man, you know, he was like, wow. You know what? That just let me know that whatever was said, it resonated. Amen. So I'm going to pray with her first. Amen. Since she told me, amen, to pray. I'm going to pray with her. Is that Miss LaShawn? Come here. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's like the Lord is showing me that tradition and religion is what tries to bind your hands. It's like, it's the old way of doing things. But the Lord says, in this season, I desire to bring you outside of the box. You see, in many of the places that you've been, there has been limitations. There has been limitations. You've been limited by what you can do, by what you can say, by where you can go. Glory to God. But the Lord said, I have called you as a minister. And the Lord said that there is fire in your belly. Glory to God. You see, the enemy likes to try to quench the fire. God, the Bible says to quench not the Holy Ghost, quench not the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. And it is, oh my God, you got to be careful with tradition and religion, because they want to quench what's on the inside of you. They don't want you to speak, they don't want you to preach, they don't want you to prophesy. As long as you hear, I'm the pastor. Glory to God. And that's true and all that. Glory to God. But even God sent Nathan, glory to God, to prophesy to David, who was the king, because he needed to get a word to him. And I'm not just saying that you're going to prophesy and things like that, but what's in you cannot be hindered. The moment you begin to get hindered, you will get stagnant. You say, I don't want to go there. I don't want to be there. I don't feel like they receive me. I don't feel accepted. I don't feel part of it. So just recall. Give me the whatever like that. Hallelujah. You will turn, you will feel like, not that you want to give up on God, but you want to give up on just doing church. But we are the church. Glory to God. The body rightly joined together. Everybody say together.
Together.
We have to do this together. And oftentimes people see what they want to see and who they want to see it in.
Ah, that's it right now.
People see, amen, what they want to see and who they see it in. You can be just as anointed as the person sitting next to you, but because you're not a part of the clique, they're going to use the person next to you and they're going to look over you. But I decree and I declare, I just saw the dove, the Holy Ghost. The Bible says that when Jesus was baptized, glory to God, by John the Baptist, the Bible says that the Holy Ghost, it came down, it descended like a dove. I decree and declare that your glory will be on your life from this day forth, like a dove. Glory to God. And I thank God. Hallelujah. I'm starting to hear some of what Mother was talking about. The Lord said, not only are you called the youth, but ladies. Glory to God. The Lord says, I shall use you. And one sign that you know that I'm a true prophet, the Lord is going to open doors for you to go into shelters. You're going to go into a place like this shelter, and there's going to be ladies in this place. And the Lord is going to use you. And the Lord said, you're going to minister to people that's been tempered with. They've been tempered with. They've been molested. They've been beat. They've been through some tough things. They've been through domestic violence. Glory to God. They've been through losing their houses and things like that. And the Lord is going to open up doors for shelters. You're going to go on rescue missions. And you're going to go in these places where these women are. And the Lord said, my hand shall be upon your life. And the Lord said, I kept you alive for such a time as this. I kept you alive. And the Lord said, even witchcraft was worked in your life before. But the Lord said, that thing is broken. Even now, I destroy witchcraft. I cancel the assignment of the devil. The Lord said, spiritual wickedness in high places. There was a time in your life when you kept trying to turn away from this certain thing, from this certain person. You kept trying to get away from it. You kept trying to get out of it. But you kept turning back to it. And the Lord said, that strong man is broken for you. Any magic, black or white, glory to God. The Lord said none of it will work again in your life. And the Lord said the Holy Ghost shall rest upon your life and upon your head. And the Lord said as you lay down, sometimes you get down on your knees like this when you pray and you lean forward like that. The Lord says when you pray and when you bow before me, the Lord says I'm going to give you a double portion. I'm going to give you more. And the Lord says I'm renewing you. I'm renewing your mind. I'm renewing the Lord says I'm renewing your circle. Even your circle is being renewed. Glory to God. Don't waver if God is pulling you. If he's pulling you in a direction and if he's opening new doors for you, don't you get afraid. Oh my God. Oh my God. And there's been some tainted love in your life. You've been through some situations with men. Glory to God. And it was tainted. It was not right. It was not good. Glory to God. You've been hurt. You've been heartbroken. But the Lord says I will cause you in this season to be healed and to be reconciled. Glory to God. The Lord says in somewhere in your relationship life there will be reconciliation in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. The Lord says I'm restoring some things. Hallelujah. I don't care if it's, if there could be somebody you don't even want no more, or don't even want to talk to, don't even want to be with, but they're all going to come back and apologize. They're going to say the I'm sorry ministry is about to show up at your doorstep. That person that walked out of your life, they're going to say I'm sorry, I shouldn't have never did that, I made a bad decision, I should have never talked to you like that back then when we was in high school. There are people that's getting ready to apologize to you, and there are people that are supposed to be doing things right now that are not doing what they're supposed to. I decree and declare that over the next 6 months, you're going to see, glory to God, what you've been praying for, what you've been asking for. You're not going to have to fight. You're not going to have, oh my God, oh my God. You ain't going to need child support. You ain't going to need nobody. The Lord said it is turning around. Because see, you can go down there to the child support office and he still don't pay and still be on the run. But the Lord said, when I get hold of him, hallelujah. The Lord said, you must fast in this season of your life. You must fast. The Lord said, you must fast. Glory to God. The Lord said, you must fast and you must pray. And the Lord said, do it without no delay. Oh my God. Come closer to me. Come closer to me. Lift your hands. I rebuke sickness in the name of Jesus. The Lord said, like the cancer got somebody else in your family, the cancer will not get you. In the name of Jesus, I break that generational curse. In the name of Jesus. And the Lord says, I will cause my anointing to come into the lives of your siblings. I don't know how many siblings you got, but the Lord says my anointing will come to the lives of your siblings. They shall be saved. They shall be healed. They shall be delivered. There shall be breakthroughs in your family, says the Lord. And there's somebody got a problem with going to jail, getting out of jail, and going back to jail, and getting out of jail, and going back to jail. The Lord said the cycles are about to be broken in the name of Jesus. And the Lord said, don't worry, delay is not denied. The Lord said, I loose you from this stress right now. I loose you from this stress. I loose you. I loose you. I loose you. And the Lord said, there's a deliverance upon your life. There is a deliverance upon your life. Somebody get that oil out the office, please. There is a deliverance out of your life. Glory to God. When I pray with you tonight, God is going to do something new in your life. There is an, oh my God, there is an impartation that is going to happen in your life. God is going to deposit some things in your life. Glory to God. He's birthing something new. And you must minister. You must preach the gospel. You must go into the shelter. You must be go behind the four walls. Oh my God. You must go beyond the walls of the jailhouse and of the prison to evangelize, to preach, and to teach in the name of Jesus. I call you anointed. I call you powerful. I call you restored. I call you revived in the name of Jesus. Y'all back up a little bit. Back up a little bit. Let her receive it. Touch. 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 Let her receive it. Touch now. Touch now. Glory. Hallelujah. of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Janice, lift your hands right here. The Lord said, doors shall open for you. The Lord says, doors shall open for you. The Lord says, as long as you stay in my will and not out of my will, the Lord says, doors will open for you. And the Lord said, people are running their mouth, but don't be distracted. They're running their mouth. There is somebody, I don't know the conversations that are being had, but there are some people, and some of them are in your shop, says the Lord. They are running their mouth, glory to God, but it is not over for you. And the Lord said, do not be distracted. And the Lord said, I will restore what the locust and the canker worm has eaten. I just heard the Lord say, remember the tithes that you have given. The Lord said, remember how you have sown and the things that you have done for others. The Lord said, this is the appointed time that the same way you have blessed other people, I shall cause blessings to come upon your life. And the Lord says, nobody know it, but you were so hurt and you felt so empty and you felt so hurt and so down and out at one time of your life, and you begin to recall, you begin to give up and throw in the towel, and nobody can even really see it. You was ready to go back to smoking and things like that, but nobody can see it. But the Lord said, because you got yourself back together, because you keep your eyes on God, the Lord said, I'm going to cause the finances that you need to come. And the Lord said, I'm going to cause all your bills to be paid in the name of Jesus, glory to God. And the Lord says to tell you that it is not over for you. It is not over for you. And God said, I'm not done with you. I'm not finished with you yet. And the Lord said, you will not be programmed. The Lord said, there are people that want to program you. They want you to be their robot. But the Lord said, you will not be nobody's robot. The Lord said, you will not be programmed. The Lord said, you will not be programmed. But you will operate under the anointing. Glory to God. Rabasota Bahaya. The Lord said, you cannot allow people to pull you into their world. You must pull them into your world. The Lord said, you cannot let them pull you into their world. God said, you must pull them into your world. And the Lord said, you're on the right track. And the Lord say, in this season, I promise you, over the next 4 days, God is going to expose to you every snake in your life, in your shop, in your family. Every snake will be hit by fire. They will be exposed. Snakes don't like fire. If any fire is burning, snakes got to come out of the bushes. I command the glory, the power. If they talked about you, it's going to come back to you. If they owe you money, it's going to come to you. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that a season of exposure comes now. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And the Lord said, your daughter will be pregnant again, and don't be hard on her. The Lord said, don't be hard. The Lord said, remember what you've been through in your life. The Lord said, as it pertains to that older child, the Lord said, that is your ministry. The Lord said, that is your ministry. The Lord said, you can't preach and teach and lead other people and give up on the ones in your house. The Lord said, there is an anointing on your life to destroy everything your daughters are fighting, everything they are battling. Glory to God. And the Lord said, that Tammy Green is like a mama. And the Lord said, listen to the words that come from her mouth, for they are sincere. I hear the Holy Ghost. The Lord said, you don't want to go back to the murky water. You don't want to be drowning in sin. And the Lord said, that is your life raft. When you speak to her, you will receive life every time. If you're hurting and you get on the phone with Tammy Green, you will receive life in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to speak and prophesy to your family, to your household. Glory to God. You tell your daughter, it won't be always like this. You won't go through this always in your life. You won't always be broke. You won't always be feeling unloved. Glory to God. Mama been through it. Glory to God. And even if they don't listen, you keep preaching. You keep speaking. You keep decreeing. You keep declaring. Because there's a matter of time before you're going to see what you said. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let them laugh at your relationship. The Lord said that man will change. Let them laugh. Hallelujah. The Lord said he shall change. Ramasota. The Lord said nobody knows the bond you have with him. They don't know the bond. The deep part of it. They just know the outer part of it. They know the shell of it, but they don't understand the yoke part of it. And the Lord said that man is going to change. Ramasota. And the Lord said you must continue to pray for his family. And I don't even know if he got children, but it's like a daughter, something like that. Somebody's daughter. I ain't gonna say if it's Marcus's, but somebody got a daughter near you. The Lord said you must pray. So it might not be him, but it's near that family. It's near that family. The Lord said you got to pray and cover for this household. As a matter of fact, I see what it is now. It's his sister. Not the one that lost the baby though. It's the dark skinned one. The hard one. The Lord said you must pray. You must pray. The same one that talk about you. You play too much and all of that stuff right there. The Lord said you got to be the one to pray for them. You got to be the one to decree and declare over their lives. Holy Ghost. The Lord said the anointing on your life is touching their life. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. The Lord said you're not a failure. You're not a failure. You're not a failure. Glory to God. And the Lord says, I'm going to restore the bond. The enemy like to attack relationships in your life. Anybody you love or anything you love, he try to throw a damper in that. And sometimes you feel like people don't understand you. Sometimes you think they don't hear you. So you just shut down, glory to God. But the Lord says that you are a sweet girl. The Lord said there is pain in your heart. But the Lord says, I will heal you of the pain. I will heal you of what you rabasota mahaya, of what you cover and what you hide and what you carry in your room. Rabasota mama sakta. And the Lord said, you won't hide behind the music. You won't hide, glory to God, behind the makeup. And you won't hide like the other students. Redo soto. And you won't run to the world. But the Lord says, I have called you to be holy. And the Lord says, I have called you to be anointed. And the Lord says, you will go to college. And the Lord says, you will have scholarships. And the Lord said, you will be effective. You will be a leader. You shall be top of your class in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. I don't want you to pick an easy thing in life. I want you to pick something hard, like a lawyer, like a doctor. Because the Lord said that you will succeed. And you shall have success. The Lord said, don't pick an easy thing. I see FAMU school a lot. Redo soda mahaya. I see billboards that lawyers be on. Rabasota mahaya. Rabasota mahaya. The Lord said you will succeed if you believe. If you believe, you will succeed. You will succeed, and it won't be hard. Rabasola Mahaya. And the Lord said, glory to God. The Lord said, carry my anointing with you. Carry my spirit with you. Carry my glory with you. Redo Sora Mamama Sakara. I decree and declare that you shall have love in your life. In this season of your life like never before. Her heart longs to be loved. Not by anybody, but by the right people. But by the people that are supposed to love her, and they are not loving her. She only want to feel loved back. But there is an anointing upon her life. There is an anointing upon her life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Makuida and Wally, I want to pray with you all. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Marsha, come up here. LaCordia, come up here. Amen. Glory to God. Just go down. Hallelujah. Y'all come right here, brother. Hallelujah. Grant, let them by these. They were. Hallelujah. Come here, Wally. I want to say to you that you tried the church thing, you go to church, you clap your hands, and you see what goes on. You're quiet in here, but you talk at home. Glory to God. You talk in your room. You understand a lot of things. You see a lot of things, but at the same time, you're humble. And the Lord said, there is more in you than you know. And the Lord says, I desire to use you. Yes, the Lord said, I desire to use you. Rabasota behind. And the Lord says, slide over a little bit. The Lord says, don't worry about the money. Issues with money problems. Sometimes y'all don't tithe, not because you don't want to, because you got to pay a bill. That's why you don't do it. I know the Holy Ghost. It ain't that you don't want to do it in your heart, but you know you got to have a place for your kids to stay. And you be like, I know I got to do right. Listen, the Lord knows what you are going through. He sees what you are going through. And the Lord says, I'm bringing balance to your relationship. The Lord said, it's been a challenge, but I'm bringing balance. And the Lord said, Wally is a new Wally. Wally is starting to do things differently. Wally will bring you joy in this season of your life. And the Lord said, it is your faith and your boldness that's going to pull the anointing out of Wally. The Lord says there is an anointing upon his life. Hallelujah. He's been offered to go to other meetings. And I'm not just talking about churches. But I'm talking about just other stuff. But the Lord says, I show you who's Wally in the house of God. You have a stern, strong, manly spirit. And the Lord is going to use you. And the Lord said, you will not be abused. You will not be abused. Your anointing will not be abused. And the Lord says, I will use you. Hallelujah. And the Lord said, I have called you to the unjust. A lot of people, you know, they just ain't right. Glory to God. It's like people I know. And the Lord said, I have called you to them people. And the Lord says he's going to set you on fire for evangelism. When I was thinking of who I'm going to let help me with my revival, I said, my queen is going to be the person that make the connections. The Lord has already shown me what's going to happen. I know that I'm supposed to be a pastor, but I don't even think people understand what's going to happen when this revival happens. Something major is on the brinks of happening. And the Lord is going to use you. The Lord said you are left out. Sometimes you feel shame. But you don't have to feel shame. We all go through it. It's all good. Glory to God. You get to see me up close and personal a little bit. You pull right in front of the driveway. Amen. You be right there. And we live in the same neighborhood. The Lord, listen to me, my friend. The Lord said you don't have to be ashamed. This ain't Kelvin, this God telling you how you feel on the inside. It ain't that you don't want to be here. Sometimes you just feel some type of way, not even in a bad way. But the Lord is working it out. One thing about me and my wife, I'll tell you this. I might be a little crazy. My wife may be serious, but we real people. At the end of the day, we real. We we gonna keep it real. We might go through what we go through, but when it come to y'all, we gonna keep it real, 100, all the way 100. No matter how tired, no matter what it costs, no matter the price. That's why I know the pastor side of me. The way I know the pastor side of me is because my love for people, because I love people and I love them hard. I be home saying, man, Jermaine crazy, but God gonna use that boy right there. That boy got an anointing. I don't just look at the fact that he a trip. I also look at the fact that he got the Holy Ghost. If you a trip in other churches, you know what they're gonna say? I can't deal with him. He a trip. No. A father don't just look at his son as a trip. He put the belt on.
Right.
Bible says if you whip that behind, you're gonna save his what? His life. So don't get mad. You know what I noticed about this church? The moment I start talking about lesbianism and I started hitting on other stuff, people start falling away.
Right.
You know why? It's like the man of God was saying, amen. It's uncomfortable. Tight, but it's right. But I loose anointing on you. I loose the glory of God to prosper upon you. I decree and declare that you shall prosper. And look at me, Wally. Marquita will break the habits that you want her to break. Not even bad habits, but there are some habits you don't like. Put your hand on your mouth. Bless that mouth in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I don't be at y'all house, but God be there. The Lord said he's working it out. He's working it out. Amen. You know when the preacher be preaching and they be talking to the man, they be like, amen. Yeah, but preach, pastor. But God knows. God knows. And listen, God is working it out. Amen. We're all in this together. Amen. Not for form or fashion. You know what? I don't look like other preachers. I don't dress like them in the name because I don't want to. I just don't have it right now. But I mean business about who I am. Glory to God. And I decree and declare that you all are going to stand firm. Your music ministry will grow. Amen. And the Lord said, the season where a damper was put on you, you made it out of that. That old manager thing and all that, you are past that. The Lord say, that don't even affect you. You don't even talk about it. You don't even think about it. It don't even come out of your mouth. And let me tell you something. The Lord is telling me to tell you this because you got to continue in that direction, in that ministry. You must continue flowing in that way. Now listen to me. You want beats from a particular person that, and the Lord say, AJ gonna give you the beats. That's what the Holy Ghost said. And listen, he talk about money and stuff like that, but he gonna give you some beats. Watch and see what I tell you. He gonna give it to you. He gonna, I don't know why, come on over to the house. You gonna come right over to the house. And I'm saying 200 and 150 he be talking about. He gonna be like, don't even worry about it right now. Just go ahead and do what you gotta do. Well, I'm telling you, God is about to give you the desires of your heart concerning that music ministry in you. Glory to God. The Lord told me to tell you he cannot fail. Cannot fail. Come here, Marsha, lift your hands. This is my girl right here. When I get a lot of money, I'm going to help out my wife clothes. Hallelujah. No, for real. She went and bought my wife some dresses. I was like, man, listen. I said, everybody can't do this for Brianna right here. Because I know what it's like to shop with her. Glory to God. She got her own style. She got an A+ on everything she bought. She did an excellent job. I'm for real. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sometimes you feel crazy. But stuff you do, people you let back in your life, you feel like, I knew I sinned and did it. You feel crazy for the decisions that you make in your own life. But it's just because of your heart, too. The Lord said, in this season of your life, my manna will come upon your life. The manna is the Holy Ghost. The Lord said you will be anointed in this season of your life. And the Lord said, don't worry about who fall off. The Lord said, don't worry about who critique. That means they talk. There's even people that talk about this church around you. The Lord said, don't get caught up in that. The Lord said, because you will receive an anointing, an impartation right here. And the Lord said, I will meet you in your room. It is in your room where your children can see behind these closed doors when you carry your biggest burdens. Your room is full of baggage. But the Lord said, I will loose you from the pain, from the hurt. And the Lord said, self-destruction. A lot of what you go through, you inflict it on yourself. You got to learn how to say no. You got to learn how to say no. And the Lord said, I don't see her here, but the Lord said, he's going to do something between you and your oldest child. Sometimes she can be mouthy. But the Lord said, I will touch the household. I will touch the family, glory to God. And the Lord said, the disrespect that you have endured at times, glory to God. The Lord said, you're going to see that thing turn around, glory to God. And the Lord said that they are going to finish school, glory to God. You have concern about school with one of them. You just want them to get an education. You just want them to go in the right direction. And the Lord said that even you, the Lord said, you must go back to school. The Lord said, because he's going to make you a teacher. I know you've been in the business of daycare, but God wants to now take you up. I saw a chalkboard. I saw a big classroom. The Lord is going to increase you. He's going to add to you. And I hear the Lord say, come out from among them. Come out from among them. He shut up Ohoya. Come out from among them in the name of impartation now. The Lord said, come out from among them. Everybody that don't want to be right and live right, get out of the circle. Don't let them drag you to the devil. The Lord said, for I shall anoint you in this season. My blessings shall be upon your life. And the Lord said, every devil that's been agitating you, the Lord said, he's going to deal with them people. He's going to deal with them. There's some people that's been agitating you. They're even on your job, even people you work with, getting on your last nerves, agitating you. The Lord said, I'm getting ready to promote you. I'm getting ready to elevate you. You ain't going to have to see them no more. You ain't going to have to talk to them. Oh, yeah, I know when I'm in the pain of God, when the Holy Ghost is flowing. God said, they've been agitating you, but I'm going to bless you. And the Lord said to tell you, you're blessed beyond measures. Sometimes you don't even know how you're going to get gas in your car, but the Lord said, you are blessed beyond measure. And the Lord said, I'm going to take you beyond $20. Sometimes it seems like after you pay all of your bills, after you do everything you need to do, you left with $20. That's the amount. That's the amount that you left. $20 exactly. When you give up all your bill money, when you do everything you need to do for your children, get the food every day, you're left with $20. The Lord said, this is the season of overflow. You will not be left with $20 anymore. God said, I'm going to prosper you. I'm going to elevate you. I'm going to cause favor to flow, abundance to come. I release it, said the Lord. The Lord said, if you stay in my presence and under my umbrella, I will bless you, said the Lord. Rabba Soda Mahari. Hallelujah. Where's that Deshaun? Come here, LaGuardia. Come here. I just heard her name and I heard what God told me to do. Come and lift your hands up here. We about to get out of here. Discern. The Lord said, I give you discernment. 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 Eyes to see. Ears to hear. But the say of the Lord, discernment. Dreams and visions. Sight to the blind. You were blind, but you will not see. And I'm not talking about literally, I'm talking about in the spirit. Glory to God. I don't know where you're at in your relationship life, but men will be attracted to you you in this season of my life. Are you married? You married. You be careful. That's why I said, I don't know where you are in your relationship life. I see attractions in you. Attractions. Glory to God. Be careful of attractions. Attractions. Be careful of the past. When I was praying for you, I was talking about the past and how people are going to come back and say, I'm sorry, and things of that nature. Be careful of the past. I know what I'm talking about. The Lord said, it ain't your fault somebody chose to get high. The Lord said, I will reveal this to you. That's the word of the Lord for you. Be careful. Be careful who you're on the phone with. Be careful who you talk to. If it's a man, be careful. If you got a job and they on your job, be careful. Rabasota Malai. They want more than the conversation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Lord, I just pray a strength in the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Evidence. Lift your hands. The Lord says, I fill you with the Holy Ghost. Let me show you how to catch up my hair. Put your arms like that. There you go. Father, in the name of Jesus. The Lord says the anointing is your portion. Come on, Mama Helen. Come on, Miss Bright. Come on, Miss Sharon. Lay your hands upon her. The Lord said you are about to embark in a new season. Something about seasons, and I'm not trying to get you to come to my church. when God want to do something different in you, he changed your season. No matter if they paid me $40,000, no matter if they gave me a free car, no matter that I had a free house that I lived in, didn't want, but all I paid was my life here. That was my life. Sit on the platform, chill. But when the Lord began to say, you got to get out of here, I kept saying, Lord, I don't know where I'm going, but I got to go. I know Satan's amazing, but God, you are God. And let me tell you something. You feel a certain type of way in your spirit, not because the church is bad, but it's something new that God want to do in you. It's something that God is trying to show you about you. And you're not, and you have got what you're going to get from there. Glory to God. It'll even seem like the messages will come monotonous. That means they'll start sounding the same to you. Why? Because you're so full of that. But as you graduate to something new, to something fresh, it don't mean that wasn't good, because Zach was a great preacher. But then God will shift your season. And it's not about numbers. It's about destiny. Your spirit is calling for something. And you need to ask God, what is it calling for? In the name of Jesus. The Lord said there will not just be performances and lights, camera, action. The Lord said he want to give you more than a performance, more than entertainment. Rebo sotoba, oh la mama masata bahaya. Rebo sotoba. The Lord, I'm telling you, I'm hearing from God. You gotta be careful in those around you that you don't idolize a man above God. That ain't in every church, but it's in some of them. It was so in mine. The Lord wants to use you. He wants to fill you. And he wants to do a new thing in you. But it'll be hard to happen where you are because of the perception of you, your past, your lifestyle, what they heard, what they know. But the Lord says, you are called. You are anointed. You, God say, tonight is your night of impartation. Rebo soto. Hala mama mama masata bahaya. Rebo soto. Rebo soto. The Lord said there was a time you was at a reception around these same people, sitting at tables with them, and you didn't even feel like you belonged there. You didn't feel comfortable, and you keep fighting, and you keep battling, and the Lord says, I'm healing you. Your season is changing. Hallelujah. Your season is changing. The Lord said you like the woman with the issue of blood. Stress has even caused you to bleed in your life. But in Jesus' name, I just want you to labor and let the anointing of God touch you. The Lord said you have a governing anointing. You have a strong anointing on your life. It is on your life. Fire. Fire. The Lord said, I will restore you from the pain of the tragedies. Not just one, but the tragedies of your life. And the Lord said, there are Judases that came up against your life. Judases. People that are wolves and sheep's clothing. Supposed to be saved, but talk about you like a junkyard dog. The Lord said, Judases. Judas was an apostle. He sat at the table. There are some preachers that speak even evil of you. But the Lord said, favor is upon your life. The Lord said, favor is upon your life. The Lord said, the glory of God. It's upon your life. And the Lord says, I shall strengthen you. And the Lord said, your days of working hard and laboring are numbered. I know you still work. I know you're still laboring. And I'm not saying quit. But the Lord said, the days of working hard and laboring, those days are numbered. The Lord said, I give you a ministry to the prisons. And like the Lord said, don't worry about how you're going to get in there, for you shall go into prisons. And you shall preach to the lost. And the Lord said that you will not only preach to them, but you will baptize them. A lot of people can baptize people. But when you baptize people, something will happen during the baptism. There's a lot of people that baptize, but when you baptize, said the Lord, something will happen. And the Lord said the oil of the Lord is upon your life. You will be strong with a microphone, but you will be very modest and humble. And you will walk in humility. When you're not on the microphone. And the Lord says he's about to touch your bank accounts. I saw Chase Bank, but that don't mean your bank is Chase Bank. It just means God is going to go to your bank. The Lord says, I will bless your bank account. Every place where you keep money, money shall overflow now. In Jesus' name. You're not going to need 8 hours, glory to God. You're going to need one divine connection, glory to God. In the name of Jesus, the Lord said, you've been sent, you've been called. And the Lord said, I have given you the keys to the kingdom, that whatsoever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven, and whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said there's a good report coming for somebody in the doctor. Somebody, maybe you and your wife been praying for somebody in your family, maybe even you yourself. But the Lord said a good report is coming. So whatever that CAT scan could have said, whatever that MRI could have said, whatever the blood work could have said, the devil is a liar. The Lord said a good report is coming. A good report is coming. I saw your car. And the Lord said, your car is about to change. And the Lord said, because you have this desire, for some reason, I'm going to give you the van. For some reason, it's to pick up people. I heard the Lord say resources are coming in to the outreach ministry. The Lord say if you just ask for what you need, it's going to come to you. Even cars will come. Anything you ask the Lord for, just like you told me, if you need furniture, it's going to come. If you need clothing, it's going to come. The Lord say I will replenish. Right now it may seem like it's low, but the Lord said, I will replenish. I will replenish. And the Lord said, just as you said at card tables. Card tables. I see like card tables. The Lord said, even as you sat at the tables with men, the Lord said, I will use you at tables to minister and to empower and to preach and to lead and to teach men how to be men. In the name of Jesus. I loose your blood pressure right now. It will not be high in the name of Jesus. I command your body to be made whole. I give Jesus your health. I decree and declare that your health is in the hands of Jesus. Opportunity. Come on, let me pray for you.
You can't let nobody hold you back.
The fact that you will know that this is from God is you feel held back at times. You feel constricted. You feel restrained. Hallelujah. And the Lord said, don't worry about church. You know that you're called to preach. You know that you're called to have it. The Lord said, don't worry about it. In due season, it's going to all open up to you. And I'm going to tell you what it's going to be like. It's going to be like a thing like kind of like rescue mission type of thing. It's going to be a shelter. It's going to be a church. It's going to be a place for addictions. All in one. All wrapped up in one little thing. It's going to be like a place of restoration and healing. Glory to God. I'm telling you, the Lord is about to use you. And the Lord said, the justice you want, you're going to get that too. Hallelujah. And judgment has even hit the lives of one of them already.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Lord. Yes.
The Lord said, you don't have to do nothing. You don't have to say nothing. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I shall repay. And they is not enough. The Lord said, all of those young men, whether they're your son, friends, or the mother homes, they all need Jesus. They all need to be saved. And we are the ambassadors of Christ to this wretched, wicked generation. I thank God right now for strength, renewed strength. I pray that you would prophesy. I pray that you would open your mouth and speak. And decree and declare. I even see the, I know you said you got off Facebook and I'm almost done. I know you said you got off. But you're going to go live and you're going to minister to people. You're going to do it. You ain't going to feel like doing it, but you're going to do it. And it's not going to be like you praying for them. You're going to literally be encouraging them. People travel all the way to Houston. They don't come to my church, but they travel there a whole lot of them. Because God told me to pray for people on Facebook Live. They said, we just following you. God has put a ministry in you. And the Lord says he's going to even use you to minister and to encourage people. Hallelujah. I don't know why, but I sing like a toast. A toast is like happiness. It's like joy. Hallelujah. The Lord said, I'll give you joy. I'll give you joy. I'll give you joy. Hallelujah. Ida ba 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 shibora ma 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 sa. And the Lord said, you don't have to worry about Brooke. I see Brooke in your head so big. I can you so worried about Brooke right now. The Lord said, you don't have to worry about that. I will take care of Brooke. I'm telling you, I see it. And the Lord even says, things she may say or do, she don't even mean it. She hurt herself. But to God, I'm telling you, I see the Holy Ghost. The Lord said, I'll fix it. And the Lord said, she loves you and she needs you right now. Rabba Soda Bahai. Rabba Soda Bahai. You're going to help raise that baby. And the Lord said, I'm going to restore your joy. And the Lord said, I'm going to bless Sean, whoever that is. Hallelujah. Redo soda, mama, 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 santa. Redesede bo shata bahaya. The Lord said, I'll give you double for your trouble. In the name of Jesus. And the Lord said, you made some mistakes, you failed, you went back. But the Lord said, you're not going to repeat it again. You feel so bad when you do that, when you mess up. You feel so bad. You feel so unworthy. But the Lord said, you're not going back down that road. All you say is, I got to be there for my grandbabies. And the Lord knows that you will be there for them. It's going to be all right, saith the Lord. The praise of God shall keep you from falling. Lord, bless Mama Sam in the name of Jesus. Give her a double portion of your love. Use her the more in this church. She has proven herself to be faithful. Lord, use her in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, stand to your feet all over the building. Children got school tomorrow. Church, back here, glory to God. Lift your hands. Lord, I thank you. I thank you for the Spirit of the living God. The Spirit of rejoicing. Loose that glory over our lives. The rest of this year, we shall rejoice in the Lord, now and forevermore. Jermaine, the Lord just said, whole. He's about to make you whole. You've been fighting, but the Lord says, I'm going to make you whole. And the Lord says, I'm going to cause you to live holy. And this is how you're going to start praying. You're going to start praying on your face. You're going to find yourself on your face. It's like God showed me even when we was in a certain place at a service. You was on your face like that. And the Lord said, when you're face down like that, he's killing you and he's raising up your soul. And the Lord said, you're going to preach. You're going to prophesy. You're going to lay hands on the sick. And they're going to recover. And the Lord said, you will minister and have a ministry of your own. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So Lord, hallelujah, my God. For some reason, I just heard a prophetic word for this church, and I'm going to release it, and we're going home. The Lord said this church will be like the church of the Philippians. When I go home tonight, I'm going to read that whole book. But the Philippian church was one of Paul's best giving ministries. Be it unto us as the Holy Ghost has released it. Let the spirit of hospitality, of love that came upon the Philippian church, let it come down. And Father, we rebuke the spirit of the Corinthian church. Division, gifted, but against one another. We call for that spirit that you're releasing for this season, for this time. Lord, I pray for Florida. There's a number five. Category 5 hurricane out there in the water. I pray, Lord, that you cover our state. In the name of Jesus. I give you the praise. I give you the honor. And I give you the glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Y'all have a safe drive home.
And pick up some trash around you, please, if you don't mind. Thank you. Thank you.